Tell me why we shouldn't kill you now. The conclave is destroyed. Everyone who attended is dead, except for you.
A little bit of tutorial here, just to make sure that we're on the right page here. But of course, we're familiar with the dialogue wheel in previous BioWare games. And similar to Dragon Age 2, the icon that shows up when you choose it gives you an idea of what the tone is supposed to be, if there's a particular slant one way or the other. It also gives very interesting or important story information, such as whether something will be regarded as starting a fight or flirtatious or beginning a romance or all that kind of stuff. It's shown here.
I think I'm responsible. Explain this. I can't.
What do you mean you can't?
I don't know what that is, or how it got there.
You're lying!
We need her, Cassandra.
So here we have something that suggests regret. Is the crying eye, something that's aggressive and forthright, which is, shows the power hand there. Thoughtful response, or kind of standoffish here. So again, this kind of gives you an idea to kind of build your the personality of your character here. By the way, I'll go ahead and mention here that the winning vote for the character's thoughts on religion was agnostic. And so our character is going to be kind of on the fence when it comes to whether the activity that's going on is kind of divine in nature or not.
I don't understand.
Do you remember what happened? How this began?
I remember running. Things were chasing me and then... A woman?
a woman. She reached out to me, but then...
Go to the forward camp, Liliana. I will take her to the rift.
What did happen?
It will be easier to show you. It's a massive rift into the world of demons that grows larger with each passing hour. It's not the only such rift, just the largest. All were caused by the explosion at the Conclave.
An explosion can do that?
This one did. Unless we act, the breach may grow until it swallows the world. Each time the breach expands, your mark spreads, and it is killing you. It may be the key to stopping this, but there isn't much time.
As usual, asking questions is usually optional, but often gets you a little bit of background information as to what's going on.
You say it may be the key. To doing what?
Closing the breach. Whether that's possible is something we shall discover shortly. It is our only chance, however. And yours.
You still think I did this? To myself?
Not intentionally. Something clearly went wrong.
And if I'm not responsible?
Someone is. And you are our only suspect. You wish to prove your innocence? This is the only way.
I understand.
Then
I'll do what I can. Whatever it takes.
They have decided your guilt. They need it. The people of Haven mourn our most holy, divine Justinia, head of the Chantry. The Conclave was hers. It was a chance for peace between mages and Templars. She brought their leaders together. Now they are dead. We lash out like the sky, but we must think beyond ourselves. As she did. Until the breach is sealed. There will be a trial. I can promise no more. Come. It is not far.
Where are you taking me?
Your mark must be tested on something smaller than the breach.
All right, standard movement controls here, as in most Dragon Age games. The ability to, I'm not sure if jumping is, it shows how long since I played the previous games. I'm not sure if jumping is a new mechanic. I think it is, actually. As usual, it's real time. You can pause the action if need be. Usually I find I don't have to, though. And of course we see Cassandra, who we haven't seen since the end of the second game, but this time she's actually one of our companions. Whoa. We're going to see that a lot, scattered bodies of both Templars and mages due to the explosion. Frame rate looks pretty good. Hopefully it'll stay that way.
The pulses are coming faster now. The larger the breach grows, the more rifts appear, the more demons we face.
How did I survive the blast?
They said you stepped out of a rift, then fell unconscious. They say a woman was in the rift behind you. No one knows who she was.
Since I already did it by accident there, control is to pause, as always.
Something farther in the valley was laid waste, including the Temple of Sacred Ashes. I suppose you'll see soon enough.
So we're actually in the point in the Frostback Mountains near where the ashes used to be kept. We were actually in this general vicinity back when Warden Vexus took his party up here to find the ashes to cure all Eamon. Yikes! And usually right click is your basic attack. Plus we have a couple initial spells here, which we can activate just by using the number keys that they're associated with. The only thing that's a little bit annoying is that manual attacks require you to keep clicking the bows.
It's over.
Drop your weapon now.
And occasionally we'll get some special responses based on our class, and here's one. So whenever we have the hand with the star, this is something that only mages are given the option of saying. For example, yeah, we wield magic, so we don't technically need the staff. The staff just helps channel it.
Do you really think I need a staff to be dangerous?
Is that supposed to reassure me?
I haven't used my magic on you yet.
You're right. You don't need a staff, but you should have one. I cannot protect you. I should remember you agreed to come willingly. Take these potions. Maker knows what we will face.
Where are all your soldiers?
At the forward camp, or fighting. We are on our own for now.
And here are the potions down below. You can only carry a set number of them. And that's for your entire party. Yes, we know about
there,
abilities.
Watch out.
I just explained those earlier.
If we flank them, we may gain the advantage.
And of course, since we are a mage, that does mean that most of the time we will be letting our companions, who are martially gifted, take the brunt of the damage. While we'll be standing in the back rank. There will also eventually be specializations for each class. I can't remember if there's two or three per class. So as a mage, we'll be able to be a little bit more specialized later on in the game.
Up on the hill. It's a time. attack from a distance.
Ah, yes. And again, as a ranged character, our priority should in fact be other ranged enemies. And also, another carryover is if you're kind of wondering where anything that's interactable is, you can always hold down the tab button as you're wandering around, and anything that you can interact with will kind of pop up with its own little label. More on the way. Our lightning attack has a somewhat amount of multi-hit nature to it. It will hit multiple enemies if they happen to be nearby to the first one it gets hit. I think we need to go up this way. Again, since I'm focusing on the story, I won't be looking at every single nook and cranny.
You'll see soon. We must help them.
And that's just for timing purposes. I don't want this Let's Play to have to drag out too long. Plus, I don't always have interesting things to say, as you may have noticed in previous Let's Plays. I like to have the story just move on. I see a familiar dwarf. There's the man himself.
Before more come through.
But who is this?
What did you do?
I did nothing. The credit is yours.
You mean this?
Whatever magic opened the breach in the sky also placed that mark upon your hand. I theorized the mark might be able to close the rifts that have opened in the breach's wake. And it seems I was correct.
Meaning it could also close the breach itself?
Possibly. It seems you hold the key to our salvation.
Good to know. Here I thought we'd be ass deep in demons forever. Varric Tethrys, rogue, storyteller, and occasionally unwelcome tag-along.
How you doing, Varric?
Are you at the Chantry, or...?
Was that a serious question?
Technically, I'm a prisoner, just like you.
I brought you here to tell your story to the Divine. Clearly, that is no longer necessary.
Yet, here I am. Lucky for you, considering current events.
You gotta wonder at this point, did Cassandra go back on her word from Dragon Age 2? Because she told Varric that if he told her his story, he'd be allowed to go. I wonder if Cassandra altered the deal, so to speak.
That's a nice crossbow you have there.
Ah, isn't she? Bianca and I have been through.
You named your crossbow Bianca.
Of course. And she'll be great company in the valley.
Absolutely not. Your help is appreciated, Varric, but...
Have you been in the valley lately, Seeker? Your soldiers aren't in control anymore. You need me.
Ugh.
My name is Solas, if there are to be introductions. I am pleased to see you still live.
He means I kept that mark from killing you while you... slept.
You seem to know a great deal about it all.
Unlike you, Solas is an apostate.
Technically, all mages are now apostates, Cassandra. My travels have allowed me to learn much of the Fade, far beyond the experience of any circle mage. I came to offer whatever help I can give with the breach. If it is not closed, we are all doomed, regardless of origin.
And what will you do once this is over?
One hopes those in power remember who helped, and who did not. Cassandra, you should know. The magic involved here is unlike any I've seen. Your prisoner is a mage, but I find it difficult to imagine any mage having such power.
Understood. We must get to the forward camp quickly.
Well, Bianca's excited.
This way, down the bank. The road ahead is blocked.
We must move quickly.
And we have a full party. And just as in all Dragon Age games, the party size remains a maximum of 4. You can have fewer, but there's very little reason to ever have it, to ever not have a full party. Which means from now on, as we get new companions, we'll have to cycle them in and out.
Demons ahead.
Glad you brought me now, Seeker.
Here the tutorial forces you to have a look at the tactical camera here. And that's so that, of course, you can give various instructions to your companions. Again, if you prefer the tactical element of the game, which is, as I've said in previous Let's Plays, has not been something that I'm particularly interested in. So I usually just let the AI do its thing without having to worry too much about it. The tactical camera also gives you a nice amount of information on the enemies that you're facing, what their status is, how many hit points they have, so on and so forth. You can give instructions on where various people are to go, so on and so forth. Oops. Get myself back. Nope. Hold on. I need to turn the tactical camera back off. Let's see. Again, because usually I don't deal with it. T, that was it. Yeah, I knew it was one of those letter keys. There we go. As with often where the heroes go, things are on fire. But there's a little bit of loot around here, so we'll just collect it. I will do some amount of exploring, but again, it's just I want to keep it so that it doesn't get too crazy. There is a crafting system in this game. It's not the most complex, or particularly interesting to me. But it does give you a chance to craft some weapons that certainly look visually cool. And so off camera, I might occasionally craft a new weapon if I think it looks particularly interesting. Peekaboo. Similar to Dragon Age 2, there are status effects for various characters that will make them vulnerable to different types of combo attacks, which again promotes the kind of tactical approach to gameplay if that's your desire. Especially on harder difficulties, it becomes more and more important. Here's the first of mineral deposits. This can aid in your crafting and also helps you to develop your particular settlement. There's a slight amount of kind of resource gathering gameplay that's included, but it's not a major part of the game. Uh, Now, I thought usually there was some banter when you came up here, which is one of the reasons I did. But no one's saying anything.
I take it you're from the Free Marches.
Here we go.
Accent. I'm from Kirkwall, but you're from further east, maybe?
That's quite the A you have.
I'm all kinds of impressive.
That's a new thing in the game as far as dialogue choices go, is sometimes you have the choice to respond to dialogue that's not in an actual dialogue scene, but is in the midst of the gameplay.
We must hurry before the mark consumes her.
Like how she was flicking her hand, like it was just annoying. The actual way to go is up this way.
Are you innocent?
I don't remember what happened.
That'll get you every time. Should have spun a story.
That's what you would have done.
It's more believable and less prone to result in premature execution.
As a mage, you have a mana bar, and eventually we will have access to mana potions. Warriors and rogues have stamina bars, which serve a very similar purpose.
She's resourceful, Seeker.
We will see for ourselves at the forward camp. We're almost there.
Camera is a little jerky. Maybe I can dial down the sensitivity a little bit off camera.
Another rift!
We must seal it! Quickly! They keep coming! Help us! Die!
This is one of the main mechanics in the game. As the protagonist, the Inquisitor, you are the only one who can close the rifts. And while they remain open, wave after wave of armies will keep coming out until you close it. And you can only close it once all local enemies have been defeated. But each rift close does give you a good amount of experience so that you can actually level up.
Open the gate.
Right away, Lady Cassandra. We are clear for the moment. Well done.
Whatever that thing on your hand is, it's useful.
See, now if I go to character record, yes. Let's see. We have 2 points to spend. What kind of mage do I want to start Aurora out to be? Well, if I remember correctly, Solas is a spirit mage. So being also a spirit mage might be a little bit redundant. So I think I'll go with Storm Mage. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, we have, let's see, Energy Barrier and Lightning Bolt. It's hard not to have Lightning Bolt. As always, I really do prefer passive abilities just because I don't have to always remember to turn them on. So we'll go with increasing our lightning damage and having a Lightning Bolt to go with it. Characters level up separately. And so you do have to... Given a certain amount of experience points, one character may level up without the others immediately also leveling up. So it's something you just kind of have to keep an eye on. The attributes, however, unlike in the previous games, will level up automatically. And so you don't have a choice of what to change, if you want to lead towards a certain attribute or not. So I'm not quite sure why they changed that. Maybe it was a balancing issue. So in other words, the only things that you can customize when you level are your abilities. And that is pretty much it. Supply caches here will restore all of your various potions, at least the health and mana ones. Specialty ones that you brew yourself, though, you have to make more.
Ah, here they come.
You made it. Chancellor Roderick, this is...
I know who she is. As Grand Chancellor of the Chantry, I hereby order you to take this criminal to Valroyo to face execution.
Order me? You are a glorified clerk, a bureaucrat.
And you are a thug, but a thug who supposedly serves the Chantry.
We serve the most holy, Chancellor. As you well know.
Justinia is dead! We must elect a replacement and obey her orders on the matter.
Isn't closing the breach the more pressing issue?
You brought this on us in the first place! Call a retreat, Seeker. Our position here is hopeless.
We can stop this before it's too late.
How? You won't survive long enough to reach the temple, even with all your soldiers.
We must get to the temple. It's the quickest route.
But not the safest. Our forces can charge as a distraction while we go through the mountains.
We lost contact with an entire squad on that path. It's too risky.
Listen to me. Abandon this now, before more lives are lost.
How do you think we should proceed?
So with decisions that can actually affect the what is about to happen, they give you some indication of what the various things are going to actually do. So we can go with the roundabout way or charge right in with the soldiers.
Now you're asking me what I think.
You have the mark.
And you are the one we must keep alive. Since we cannot agree on our own.
I would think, given that Aurora is part of the mages, mages don't tend to do the straightforward approach. That's more of a Templar thing, I think. So, let's take the mountain path.
Use the mountain path. Work together. You all know what's at stake.
Liliana. Bring everyone left in the valley. Everyone.
On your head be the consequences, Seeker.
So we will be taking the mountain path to kind of sneak our way past most of the demons in order to arrive at the rift above the conclave. But my recording time is coming up short here, so we'll do that in the next video. Until then, fellow adventurers, take care.